أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن الذين يحبون أن تشيع الفاحشة في الذين آمنوا لهم عذاب أليم، لهم عذاب أليم في الدنيا والآخرة، والله يعلم وأنتم لا تعلمون. You dropped it?
Yeah.
I don't know where it went. I think I got it. Here. Okay. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم. Quran Weekly. Me and Waleed again. And I want to share with you the 18th juz, one ayah from the 18th juz today. And that is the ayah from Surah An-Nur, one of my favorite surahs in the Quran. And this is the 19th ayah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُحِبُّونَ أَن تَشِيعَ الْفَاحِشَةِ. No doubt those who love that shamelessness, inappropriateness, lewdness, indecency should spread, should become widespread and branch out. فِي الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, among those who believe. لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. They'll have painful punishment in this world and in the next. I mean, a few days now I've been giving you surah ayat about warnings. And this is an equal part of the, you know, the balance of the Quran. Allah gives warnings and Allah gives good news. And in this particular ayah, the crime that Allah mentions is people guilty of spreading inappropriateness and indecency and a lowering of the standards of shame among Muslims. And people who make it common, people who want to make it just a norm, that should happen. Then they have great punishment in this world and the next. Wallahu ya'lam. And you would think, what's the big deal? Why is this so serious a crime? Allah answers that question Himself and He says, Wallahu ya'lam. Allah, in fact, He knows. Wa antum la ta'lamun. You have no idea. You don't know. You don't know how serious this is. So what does that mean, people who spread shamelessness? This is, you know, forms of entertainment that are inappropriate and indecent. There's, you know, there are people that, you know, if you are like a Muslim and you're watching some like inappropriate music video or something, right? And you forward it to your friends, and like you share it on Facebook or something, hey, watch this, this is pretty awesome. Then you spread shamelessness. You did that. Even in this, like by two clicks, the ayah started applying to you. So you have to be careful what you spread among people and what you make common. And this is not just limited to like videos and images and things like that. It's also talk. Like, you know, if you know something scandalous or something, you know, indecent, then you don't spread it, you don't talk about it, you drop it. We don't actually, in Islam, we don't, you know, sensationalize controversy. And we don't bring it out in the community and talk about it even more and more. The context of this passage is actually, hey Baba, don't do that to the mic because then it makes a weird sound, okay? Okay? Say okay. 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 So, the context of the ayah is actually the accusation made against the mother of the believers, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, in Surah An-Nur. And she was accused of wrongdoing and this scandal had spread. And Allah says those who, you know, they want to spread shamelessness. Shamelessness is not necessarily the act, an act of indecency, but it's even the talk of indecency. That spreading is inappropriate. So if you know something happened in your community, don't talk about it. Don't openly talk about it, unless it brings some benefit. Like talk to the parents about, you know, some girl ran away from her house or something. Or you know some boy, Muslim kid that you know from the masjid or from school is dating somebody. Don't spread these things. To only talk to that people that can help with the situation, not just to anybody. Talk to his parents, talk to him, talk to her. Say, this isn't right, you know. But otherwise, it's so much fun to talk about, right? It's just easy to just spread. But it's a very, very, very serious crime. So we shouldn't, you know, just casually talk about these kinds of things. And the only additional comment I'll make is that the Quran, it actually does not explicitly talk about things, even that are, I'll call them rated R. Right, so intimacy between men and women. Quran deals with the subject, but not in an explicit way. It deals with it in a very dignified way. 8 or 9 times intercourse is mentioned, intimacy is mentioned in the Quran. Never is it mentioned literally. It's always alluded to. So Allah is not like, He's not shying away from the subject itself, but He's not going to use explicit language. And like the Arabic language is very rich, it can use those kinds of words, but Allah chooses not to do it. So even that is a problem, to say those kinds of words. Sometimes you hear them, a speaker using those kinds of words, and everybody's disturbed because we know in our nature it's not comfortable for us to hear those kinds of words. And they shouldn't be, you know, spread in this way. There's a way around them, and there's a way that we can maintain our decency and still talk about difficult things that are there to talk about. May Allah give us a really heightened sense of decency, and may Allah Azza wa Jal not make us of those who are culprits in spreading and lowering the standards of shame and lowering the standards of appropriateness among the Muslims. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.